Hey everyone, I wanted to do a kind of things that I liked in 2015, some new gear that I kind of swapped out and found to be really fun, and pieces of gear that maybe were once considered a luxury have now turned into being a mandatory part of my system, such as this umbrella. So I just have a couple things out here, and we'll kind of go through one by one, and if you don't have them and find them interesting, maybe I will point you in the right direction, and or if you do have them, tell me what you think in the comments below. All right. First up, this is the RAV Power 9000 mAh portable power bank. What I really like about this is it has a built-in lightning wire for an iPhone and also a built-in wall outlet. So it eliminates the need to carry extra wall adapters, cords, etc., etc. Again, this is a 9000 mAh. I use portable power banks in my everyday life. I love them. I throw one in my daily carry bag, and it's just a really nice piece of comfort. What I really like about this eliminates the need to fumble around with all these different cables, and everything secures nicely. And underneath there is an extra space for a USB. In addition, RAV also makes one that comes with a dedicated micro USB. But then I also have an adapter where I can slide on. It gives me a micro USB as well. So this really becomes a multifunctional. As far as the 9000 mAh goes, you always have to factor in 15 to 30% of lost power due to the heating and the energy of the battery. But I can get almost 4 full charges on my iPhone. I'm using a 6S. And so I can get almost 4 full charges out of it. And I'm gonna be using this because on my thru hike, which I'm doing this year, the Appalachian Trail, I want to eliminate clutter and things that could possibly get lost or damaged. So having this, I think, will reduce a lot of those issues. It does take about 4 hours to fully charge. But here's what's nice. Now, the weight-wise, this is 8.6 ounces, which initially you think to yourself, that might be a lot of weight for somebody that's into more of an ultralight backpacking style, such as myself. But in comparison, this is a new trend. This is a 5200 mAh, which I've had for 3 years now, and I absolutely love, and I still use the laser because my cat loves to chase it around. But along with it, I have to add in a wall adapter, an Apple lightning wire cable, and the USB cable for the charger to here. Now all this, and keep in mind, this is only a 5200 mAh, weighs in at 7.6 ounces. So 1 ounce is less than the RAV Power, but I'm getting almost 4,000 more mAh on this. So this is one where I really have to weigh weight versus efficiency versus hassle, being hassle-free, etc. So again, this is the RAV Power 9000 mAh. I believe they also make a 3000 mAh version that comes with the dedicated lightning wire and wall outlet. And this is pretty much the only one I could find that had good views. There's power sources out there that come with a dedicated lightning wire, but they won't come with the wall outlet, or else they'll get one that comes with dedicated wall outlet and the micro USB cable. So I really want one that came like this, because I don't have anything in my kit that requires a micro USB. Okay, so that again is the RAV Power 9000 mAh. Next up is the EuroScrim Light Flex umbrella. And this is an ultralight umbrella that weighs 8 ounces like this. You could trim off the cord, and I believe that'll take an extra 1/2 ounce off. But I actually use the cord when I go hands-free, I put my sternum strap through this. And I'm going to do a video on my whole setup for how to hike hands-free with an umbrella. But it's this was, I believe these were the same makers that made the famous Go Light umbrella. Go Light goes out of business. Euroscrim still continues to produce this. But really light, actually really durable. I've had this in some really windy conditions. Maybe 20 to 25 miles an hour wind. I mean, nothing like monstrous, but it's held up real well. I use it as my daily umbrella because I didn't really see a need to carry another umbrella. But it's just very well made and very strong. I'm gonna do bad luck here. And there's the inside and the outside here. I mean, as far as umbrellas goes, it's just an umbrella, but it's light. And what I started finding was, this was a luxury item initially when I would go on just a one overnighter, because I was like, I can take an extra 8 hours, or 8 ounces, I'm sorry. And what I started finding was, by going hands-free, even though I wear a rain jacket, it keeps the driving rain off your face. But here's the other really neat side bonus that I get is when I put this on, it goes over the top part of your pack. And if anybody has struggled with rain and pack covers, you know that a pack cover never really fully protects your pack from rain, because you get rain that comes in through the sides and it pulls up in the bottom of the pack. By having this over top of you, it deflects the rain from going through the top part of the pack cover and pulling at the bottom. And that's the one of the biggest bonuses about having an ultralight umbrella like this. Also, I use an Altiplex Z-Pax tent, and I will open this up and put this in my vestibule, and it just adds another layer of protection in front, and I can put my my trail runners underneath this umbrella in my vestibule and know that no rain is going to touch it. So it really kind of becomes multi-purpose in open weather. A lot of Pacific Crest Trail hikers, they'll use this in the desert portion. It just keeps the sun off you. So it really is a multi-use. I don't really look at this as just an umbrella. I look at this as part of my foul weather system. So again, this is the Euroscrim Light Flex Ultralight Umbrella. And I got this through Amazon. I believe Campmore sells them. You can also go to Six Moon Designs. They sell a variation of this as well. This also did come with a protective sleeve. I don't use it. And I believe that weighed an extra quarter ounce. But I just actually weighed this right before I talked about this, and this came out to a perfect 8 ounces. This is the Therm-a-Rest Z-Seat. And as you can see, it is just a few sections that would be of the material that was traditionally found in a Therm-a-Rest Z-Rest, or which is the accordion style sleeping pad. And I think what happened was a couple years ago, Therm-a-Rest started realizing that hikers were cutting off pieces to use to sit on, and so they actually just came out with one. This weighs 2.1 ounces. It's a closed foam kind of egg crate style feel. It's very durable. I've had this all summer long. I use it at every rest stop I would take, pull it out, sit on it. Has a yellow side and a kind of silver reflective side. And so I put my bottom on here. The other nice thing is it acts as a windbreak. I can set it up, and if I'm doing a canister stove and I don't want to use a windscreen around a canister stove, I can kind of set this up a few inches away and block some wind, and at the same time, not heating up my canister stove fuel canister. I also use this. I'll put my shoes on here at night. I'll use it as a kneel pad. As I get into my shelter, this is what I'll kneel down on as I unzip my shelter and climb inside. So again, another piece of equipment that really was, you know, initially designed to just put your butt on and has instead evolved into a multi-purpose tool. Again, this is the Therm-a-Rest Z-Seat. It weighs 2.1 ounces. And you don't have to get this one, but I really highly recommend you get something like this. I just really like this because it's accordion style and it bends. Gossamer Gear makes a sit light pad, which is really has an appearance of an egg crate foam. It's a little bit more durable. The one thing I don't like about that one is it doesn't bend. It doesn't bend as well. And so I can take two sticks, put them in the ground, slide them between this. I got myself a little natural windbreak. All right, Therm-a-Rest Z-Seat. Get one, you'll be glad you did. Okay, so this one is a real quick one. This is the Optimus Titanium Folding Spoon, and I really like it. And this weighs 0.8 ounces on my scale. Couple neat things I like. It has the polished bowl. There are long-handled spoons that kind of have that same rough titanium feel. It's not very pleasant in the mouth. And you know, if you're gonna go hiking, might as well get something that feels good when you're eating your meals. So again, this has the polished bowl and it collapses. And I'm gonna I'll show in my next piece of favorite gear that I got, why this kind of works with my system. But it's very easy, you just unfold it and it just has a little locking handle that slides down like that. And it's not going anywhere. So it goes real good. It's nice and long, gets down to the bottom of any type of pre-packaged freeze-dried meal like Mountain House or Packet Gourmet. And again, this is the Optimus Titanium Folding Long-Handled Spoon with the polished bowl. This is what I was using previously. This is the Tokes long handle, which is a, if you don't like folding handles, this is one that I really recommend, the Tokes long-handled spoon. The thing about it is I like to keep everything in my cook kit together. I really like simplicity. And I just found that this just wasn't working with my cook kit. So kind of went searching and found the folding-handled spoon. This is the Gossamer Gear Warm Sack, and what I really like about it is it serves as a koozie as well as a carrying sack for your cook kit. Now this warm sack will hold pots that have a diameter of no more than 4 inches. So nothing more than 4 inches. Unfortunately, this is the only size warm sack they make at this time. I really wish they would make different sizes. This does come in a Cuban fiber, which is what this is. This weighs 0.6 ounces. And they also make it in a Sil nylon. I'm unsure of what the weight is. It might be like 1.1 ounce or something like that. But what I really like, and this fits into my whole philosophy of simplicity and easeability, is this is one thing. In the past, what I would do is I would have a piece of Reflectix, piece of an aluminum foil to go over, and then a Cuban fiber carry sack. So it would look a little something like this. Like that. And then this would all fit down inside that. Now these three things here only weigh 0.8 ounces. It's only 0.2 ounces more than the warm sack. But again, it's one piece of equipment versus three. So naturally, I'm going to choose the one. And so it works out really well. And my cook kit can go, fits right in. This is the Tokes 650 milliliter mug, which I really love. I have an unboxing of this earlier, and this really has become a favorite piece of my equipment as well. But it fits real nice and easy in here. Yeah, I can just put it right on in, bring it up, and there we go. Now I wanted to talk about it, when I talked about my folding spoon, why I really enjoyed it is, when I do a weekend of alcohol stove, I have, this is my favorite alcohol setup right now. So I have my spoon fits in there, little piece of pack towel, my hot lips. This is the Mini Bull Designs Elite screen. So I have a little ground protectant. And so I can fill up with alcohol, light it, set this on top. And this is a titanium windscreen from Chiwiz. He makes different sizes. And so I can do that. And then I just use a buff as a pot grabber, which works out really well. So if I'm gonna cook inside this, I can just either take it off and set it in the actual koozie, or I can put my freezer bag in here and prep that up, pour the water into the koozie. So either way it works out, then I just bring it up, tie it off. So if I'm gonna do a drink, I can boil up my water, add my coffee, and then I can add my hot lips. And I can hold it just like this. So either way, it really works out well. I can, you know, hold it up. You don't get any metal in contact with your lips. And it's very easy to hold on to. And you know, you can just dump it out, put everything back in, and reclose it back up. Now, if I'm gonna carry the, if I'm gonna go a canister route, if I'm gonna go the canister route, you know, I can put my canister in here. This is the Snowpeak Light Max. Another great little stove, 1.9 ounces. Nests inside the 650 milliliter. Hot lips, pack towel. Getting back real quick. Now this is one where, and then that just goes right on top. Then I can set this right down in. Close it up, and again, everything goes in. Nice and simple. If I was using my long handle spoon, you know, it's not, it just doesn't, it's not gonna just pack down. So again, this is the Gossamer Gear Warm Sack. You can get it on their website, gossamergear.com. They make it in Sil Nylon and Cuban Fiber. This is the Cuban Fiber version. Fits up the pots 4 inches in diameter. All right, so that was the, that's the end of my favorite little kind of small backpacking items for 2015. And I look forward to seeing what 2016 brings. I hope you enjoyed. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments section. Thanks a lot.